You know what the worst part about going to a meeting is? Having to take notes. Who the heck wants to take notes? I don't know how to write. I know how to. Should I tell my audience I don't know how to read or write? That's probably concerning. In all seriousness, there is a app that I wanted to review in today's video called Airgram.io. It's a meeting productivity and management tool to enhance teams' meeting experience from plan to action. It allows you to plan before, engage during, and review after the meeting. My favorite thing about Airgram.io is the fact that I just don't have to take notes. I can keep saying it till the cows come home, but it's just that wonderful. And not only are the notes well made, they really do a good job of giving you a good editing experience of the notes to look at later. Jumping into the pricing of this one, it's 5 lifetime recordings for free, and then you get $8.99 a month. You get 10 recordings a month, and you can up the price and the amount, as you can see here. And you'll also get an agenda timer, AI topic extraction. You can create clips, search and replace, and you can even download video recording and export things into different document types like Word, Google Docs, and Notion. Notion being one of my favorite ones. Wink. It's weird. I had to like say wink so that the audio didn't cut out in my editing process. You don't want to see all my videos there. It's crazy. Really cool. You can sign up via just your email now, which is a recent update that they did. And before, you used to have to like have a Gmail and Google Calendar connected right when you signed up. Now you don't have to do that. But I did connect mine. And currently, I am working in a workspace where Calendly is like my calendar of choice for different meetings. So what I can do is, for example, I have a sync with a client of mine. I can press record, and when it records, I can choose to record the Google Meet, the Zoom, and I've already added it as a Chrome extension, which is, as you can see right here. So now what I'm gonna do is basically set up in my account. If I go to here, go to integrations, you'll see I have these set up, and you also set up auto join meetings. So join all calendar events with a Zoom link. What you can do is join all calendar events with a Google Meet link. This setting will be saved here, and you'll see your Airgram assignment in Zoom, if you had it, will be named your name and then Airgram Assistant. So if I go to this example meeting, so now I just started a new Google Meet. So what I'm gonna do is press this button, log in to continue to go to Airgram, then log in to my admin at Rise Productive account. Now that I'm logged in, you'll see that it has the option to start recording. So when I press start recording here, you'll see that some meeting notes are gonna take place very shortly. So the Airgram assistant joins, and you can go up here and press admit when they try to join the call. Hello, Airgram assistant. So I said, hello, Airgram assistant. It's funny there. And over here, you can see you can jot things down with a notepad, but it is recording the meeting and taking notes based on who's talking. So basically, if I had another person join the meeting, it would switch between those two users. And every time I take a substantial pause, it'll pull it to another time. So as you can see, there was a spot in the beginning where I spoke, and then after about a 30-second pause, it took a little break. Now from here, what I can do is I can highlight something like this example action item of recording this YouTube video, and I can take this and press add action item, or I can add a note on top of something. So I go here, press add note, and you'll see on the notepad, it took the action item that I grabbed and I pressed note twice, so it went here. So basically what you can do is, as it's transcribing, somebody could pull the different information into something very easily and also edit this text. So I could change this action item to just recording this YouTube video. You can see when the due date is, and you can set it to like Monday. You can take this, and there's actually, interestingly enough, some markdown functionality. So if I put backslash there, the ability to do H1, 2, 3, I can do agenda here and put an agenda block, and I can put section 1 of the meeting and then start this item. And then it shows you how long you should stay in this section. And if you had set a agenda prior to this, you'd be able to do that for multiple different sections of the agenda. And then when you want to end it, say for example, it's over, it'll show you how long that different section lasted. As you see, it's been transcribing this the entire time. It's asking me whether I want to add action items to the notepad. So here, what if I wanted to teach people about agenda blocks? I could highlight this, press this, go back to the notepad and do this, teach people agenda blocks. And somebody could also just keep taking notes that fit the transcription as this goes. Now say you wanted to stop recording. You'd press it here, and then it has the option for you to go to Airgram, check recording, and transcript. So if I press replay, it'll open it up right here. But then on the bottom, if I wanted to restart recording, I definitely could. So now when we get into this part of it, you'll see that it shows the different sections that it broke it down for me in, and the different notes that I had. Now, there is AI topics that are showcased. And interestingly enough, it tried to pick up Airgram, but said Airgram. I mean, that's not a real word, so I mean, it makes sense. But when it comes to date and time, it heard me say Monday when I talked about when I wanted to put the YouTube video. And then for your organization, it did hear me say YouTube. And then there is a spot right here where you can play it back and you can cycle through the different timeline on this. You can change it to 1.5 speed, faster, slower. So say, for example, I put it on 2x and press play. You can hear me talk way too fast and also see what section I'm in. And then another one is if I put skip silence on, it'll skip any dead space in the recording. On top of that, you'll see that it separates different sections by this little guy right here, and you can scroll through the timeline just like this, and it'll go across in the text like that. And if there's any words that don't line up, luckily enough, you can just go in here, and for example, like with what happened with the Airgram error earlier, if we do hello, Airgram assistant, and then fix that again. And then if I wanted to, I could actually create a clip out of this. So if I go to the part where it says YouTube, and you'll see I did Control F, and it's got its own search feature here where it can do a find and replace. So once again, if I undid that situation to wherever it said something wrong. So let's say, for example, it picked up Airgram like that twice. What I can do is I can do Control F, paste this in, and then switch it with a find and replace of Airgram and press replace all. And then it's good. Now, if I had multiple speakers in here, I could actually take this and pick what speakers I wanted to look at too, which is smart. Currently it's on all speakers and it's the same thing as one, which is just me because I was the only one that recorded it. But you can also add tags to this one. So this could be a YouTube brainstorming session, and you'll see that it has the time here and you could star this meeting because it's important. And you can go right here and you can copy this to a notepad, download the video, and you have the option to export different things to Microsoft Word, Notion, Slack. So let's try to do Notion as an example. If you go to authorize and log in here, you have the ability to add pages. So I'm gonna select different pages. Let's just do an example one right here. Do tasks and events, even though I definitely could do meeting notes. Do allow access. That's gonna redirect me back to Airgram. And I can go here, press export to Notion. And you can also take the action items and put it into tasks and events, would make more sense. So select a column for action items. Let's do name. Select a column for due dates. Let's do time. Remember my options. So let's look at the action items recording this YouTube video. If I go back to Notion, I search for this name. You'll see it actually has a Notion integration, which is pretty cool. And then I could also do the same thing and export it to things like Google Docs, Slack, and Microsoft Docs, which makes total sense. And then going back here, if I went to meeting notes in this workspace, it'll have all of your meeting notes organized here. You can check out your different starred meeting notes, recent ones, and then ones that other people have shared with you. And if for any reason you want to make some quick notes, you can go to the top right of the screen and do just that. What I really like about this view is the fact that it really only shows you what you need to, and it changes the color of what the meeting was. If it gets grayed out, that means it's happened, and it only really shows up you through the next week here because they don't want you to get too overwhelmed. And then if you go back to the calendar view, you can see farther out. And if you need to add different calendars, you can, but for me, Calendly is the only one where I will be requiring a meeting recorder. Something I really like about this software is the fact that on their website, they actually have agenda templates. So you can see that there's different ones for like marketing meetings, project meetings. So let's do this one and get this free template. You'll be able to, for example, select a meeting tool and start a recording. So say you want to copy this to a notepad, you could as well. So in that meeting I was in, I could just copy to the notepad. But if I wanted to, I could just start a meeting. So I could add it and then open Google Meet. So then if I go to a new meeting and I copy this, I could press start recording. And then in the notepad, I could paste it in there. And if I press admit, you'll see that this is the agenda template setup. So if I put this and press agenda and added different sections here or talking points, this would allow me to do the whole starting situation and track how long the different parts of the agenda were talked about. Now there is a litany of other great things about Airgram. And if you're gonna work with any sort of meeting software that'll record your audio, get agendas put out and action items even integrated to Notion, Airgram's your best option. Thanks again to Airgram for sponsoring this video, and make sure to check the link down below to get your Airgram experience started today. And check out this video to get your productivity improved today as well.